Hi, welcome all to my another video today. In this video, I am going to solve another problem in central force motion. In the last video, we have done a problem on the motion of a rocket around the Earth. And in this video, we are going to focus on a problem on a circular motion with a spring. Okay. Let me read the problem question once. The problem is a 2 kg mass on a frictionless table is attached to one end of a massless spring. The other end of the spring is held by a frictionless pivot. The spring produces a force of magnitude 3 R N on the mass, where R is the distance in meters and from the pivot to the mass. The mass moves in a circle and has a total energy of 12 joules. Find the radius of the orbit and velocity of the mass. B. The mass is struck by a sudden sharp blow, giving it instantaneous velocity of 1 meter per second radiously outward. Show the state of the system before and after the blow on a sketch of the energy diagram. C. For the new orbit, find the maximum and minimum values of R. Okay, നമ്മളുടെ ചോദ്യത്തിലേക്ക് കടക്കാം. അതായത് ഒരു ടേബിൾ ഉണ്ട്. ഈ ചിത്രത്തിലേക്ക് നമുക്ക് നോക്കാം. ഒരു മേശപ്പുറത്ത് ഒരു സ്പ്രിംഗ് വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. This table is considered to be frictionless table, and this is a spring. One end of the spring is connected to a mass, and the other end of the spring is pivoted at the center of a at this point. And the spring has got a spring constant, and a force is acting due to the spring force. And this mass is moving in a circle, and it has a velocity in this direction, and due to this radial force it moves in a circle. So my question is, the first question is find the radius of the orbit and velocity of the mass. It is a very simple straightforward question. And the second question is along this radius it is given a velocity 1 meter per second. In that case, what will be the new orbit? While it was moving in the previous case, on the time while it was moving, suddenly a force is given in this direction, radial direction, which produces extra velocity in the radial direction, that is R dot, that is 1 meter per second. And now you have to find out the new state of the system, and you have to draw in the figure energy diagram what is the new and this old state of the system. And again we have to find out the minimum and maximum values of R. That means once it is given a high energy, it will be moving in some other shape like ellipse. Now what will be the minimum radius and maximum radius, just like a ellipse? Okay. അപ്പോൾ ഈ ചോദ്യത്തിലേക്ക് കടക്കുന്നതിന് നമുക്ക് ആവശ്യമായ തിയറി നമ്മൾ പഠിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. സെൻട്രൽ ഫോഴ്സ് ബോഡി മോഷനിലെ എനർജി ഇക്വേഷൻ, ആസ് വി നോ ദ ഇൻ ദിസ് കേസ് നമ്മൾ സെൻട്രൽ ഫോഴ്സ് തിയറം പഠിച്ചപ്പോൾ അവിടെ എർത്ത് സൺ ഈസ് ബീങ് അട്രാക്റ്റഡ് ബൈ ദ ഐ മീൻ എർത്ത് ഈസ് ബീങ് അട്രാക്റ്റഡ് ബൈ ദ സൺ. സോ ദ potential energy is the gravitational force of provided by the gravitational force of attraction between the sun and the earth, where we have the terms minus g mm is the constant c. But in this case, instead of the gravitational potential, we are having a spring potential. The potential is provided by the spring force. That means this spring has a force, and that corresponds to a potential that will produce a potential energy on this mass. So accordingly we have to convert that problem into this case, and this is a very typical problem, that is a very good problem. You can see this problem in the Kleppner Mechanics by Kleppner book. Now this can be solved by this way. First of all, we just know the equation for the energy of a circular orbit or the central force motion. As we know, the kinetic energy plus potential energy. But in this case, I told you the potential energy is not gravitational potential energy, but it is the spring potential energy. The spring potential energy is already studied in the previous videos. That is given by half k r square. So this is the potential energy and this is the kinetic energy. And for equilibrium case, that means when there is no net force along the radial direction, the centripetal force is equal to the spring force. That means even in the case of the Earth moving around the Sun, the gravitational force of attraction between the Sun and the Earth is being equal and opposite to the centrifugal force. And in that case, we can equate these two terms, and from this you substitute this value of mv square in the previous energy equation. What we get is mv square is replaced by kr square, so that will become kr square is the total energy. And from this you can find the value of radius, because already they are given the energy and k is also given. So r is root of e by k, which is 2 meter, is the radius. It is a simple problem. You can directly use the equation for a formula and substitute the values and get the value of r. And now we can find the velocity also. As we know from the equation, if I know the value of k, r and k, you can find from this equation, that is v square is equal to kr square by m. So that means v is equal to root of kr square by m. So put in the values of all these things, you will get root of 6 meters is the velocity. Now the second part of this question is it is given a radial blow that changes the total energy of the system, but not the angular momentum. So angular momentum or the effective potential, but that means the effective potential depends on the angular momentum, but that doesn't changes because the energy only will change because of this blow, because the kinetic energy will change, and the kinetic energy in the direction, because MVR is changing. So the initial energy, let us find the values here. You can see it is given here. The initial energy is already given. It is 12 joules. And now find the final energy. So the final energy is the initial energy plus the extra kinetic energy, because the potential energy remains constant. And you are not... why I am saying the potential energy remains constant is because the spring is... The spring, in this case of the spring, the changes what happened that taking place in the spring, that is incorporated in the R value. So what I am saying is the total final energy, which is the kinetic energy, is that initial energy plus the extra energy, that is half mv mr dot square. So putting these values, we'll get 13 joules, that is the final energy. So in this energy diagram, you can see the circular orbit, that is E0, corresponds to the circular orbit. And when the energy is increased by giving a radial velocity, that energy has become E1. So a line is drawn just above it. That is what the E1, you can see here. And that is not the elliptical orbit, but it is something like an elliptical. This is not a circular orbit, it is an elliptical orbit. And in the previous case, as you know, the potential energy curve goes like this. That means you know that as the R value, the x axis is R and the y axis is energy. As R value decreases at some point of R, the energy decreases, becomes a maximum. And then it is a turning point for that. And that is the contributions are given in the dotted. And these two terms, these two dotted terms only contributes to become the final solid curve. And the first dotted curve, you can see here, that is the half kr square, that is the spring energy. This is not the case of the gravitational energy. It will be a different case, because gravitational energy, potential energy is minus jmm by r. That means gravitational potential energy is inversely proportional to r, but here the spring energy is proportional to r square. So this is what the potential energy due to the spring, and this is the kinetic energy due to the angular momentum. That means the angular component of the kinetic energy. So this is this two contributes to the potential, effective potential, and this effective potentials has got the turning point at this point. Now the third part of the question is that after given an energy, it becomes a new orbit, and now find out the two radius of this two new of the ellipse. That means you have to find out the two possible values of r. So how to approach this problem is that you are going to find out the effective potential, that is the potential of this system of the problem, plus the L square by 2m that is the kinetic energy which is due to the angular direction. So in this case, half kr square is the potential energy of the spring, plus m v 0 square r 0 square by 2 r square is the kinetic energy, which is the part of the effective potential energy. But we know that at the turning point, we can say the turning point is the point where the energy is just effective potential is equal to the total energy. So you can just write the effective potential becomes the total energy E1, because the potential energy, I mean the kinetic energy, becomes zero. Only the total energy is completely contributed by the potential energy. So now putting the values of this E1 in this equation, and we already know calculated the value V0, R0, all these things, and then you put it these values, and E1 also is known, and then you substitute these values, K is also known. Then you will get a quadratic equation in R. So that means the quadratic equation has got two values, two roots. Since it is a quadratic equation in R, you will get two values of R, and that two values of R correspond to the two distances. That means two values of the radius. That means an ellipse has got two radius. One is a small radius and the bigger radius. As you can see, 1.63 meter is a small radius and 2.45 is a bigger radius. That means it is moving in an ellipse. Oh, that means the that will give you the as you know, the perigee and apogee points. You can say these are the two points which is asked in the problem, and thus we come to the end of this problem. And I hope you come to the conclusion of this problem, or the three parts of the problem are solved, and that's all the end of this video. Thank you, one and all.